Good afternoon, guys. Kenny here with Brave the Wilds. So, it's been a little while since I've had a video, and, we've had some pretty awful weather here today, so, I couldn't really get outside much, so, I figured I'd just come down to, my little area under the porch here and just shoot a quick video for you. So, what I'm going to show you today is just, a few Walmart mess kits. So this one is made by Coleman, and, I'm not 100% sure which one this was made by. I think maybe Coleman made this, but I'm not exactly sure, but both of these are found at Walmart, and one of these I would definitely take with me, and one of these I would feel a little hesitant before I took it with me on any kind of trip. So, as most of us are, we are all kind of budget outdoorsmen, including myself. You know, some people obviously will spend a lot more money on some things. But, you know, some things you don't have to spend a whole lot of money on. You don't have to buy an $80 mess kit. A $20 mess kit could do you just fine. Like Dave Canterbury always says, keep it, you know, he likes to be a very common man. And, you know, I think that's important. I don't think we need to get too elaborate because it's a waste of money. Now, if you're the kind of person that doesn't mind spending a lot of money on his equipment, then, you know, that's more power to you. But, you know, a lot of us, you know, we just try and get the best value for any items that we buy. And so Walmart is definitely a very shaky store to go in for anything. I very much hate going to Walmart, and especially going to the camping section, because I know they sell you 99% of it is just crap. So I kind of just wanted to show you these two mess kits and some kind of good things and bad things about both. So we'll start with this one. This one can be found, I'm sure, for $5 or $6. Something super cheap. All it is just really cheap thin aluminum. And so the way you get it apart is just it has a wing nut right here. So we just unscrew that. And then our handle pops out. Just screw that wing nut back on. Like that. Alright. And then we have a plate. The plate is the first thing that comes off of it. Again, all of this is metal or aluminum except for one piece of it. So in that area, yeah, I'd give it a check mark for that. But you know, there are some plastic mess kits out there that may be good, but it's really no good unless you can seriously put hot water in it and or boil in it. So first thing you get is a metal plate. The next thing you have is a pot lid. Take out my steel wool. The next thing you get is a small measuring cup. This thing measures only in ounces, and it goes up to 1 cup, and that would be 8 ounces. So there you go. Then it has a small pot with a handle. And then the next thing you get is the skillet. So the number of pieces are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And so, you know, it does give you a good amount of carrying devices and containers for the price. But, you know, it's just really not a very quality mess kit at all. As you can see, it's got a ton of dents in it. It's super thin. You can see I can bend it right there. You know, that thing's okay, I guess. I mean, you can still bend it easily. This pot, what the heck are you going to boil in? It's not like you could even cook one serving of soup in it. It's just so shallow. And then, of course, the plate. Again, super thin. So, you know, I just don't think it's that good of a mess kit at all. So, would I recommend you buy this? No, I would not. However, if you're going to have a couple people over, and you want to have a really good quality, maybe just a good plate, then, you know, that would serve a purpose. I mean, it is lightweight. If you're not planning on boiling water or anything like that, yeah, it'd probably work good. But for the price, $5 or $6, it's not an awful mess kit. I've seen worse. However, if you don't treat it kindly, you will destroy it. So that's that mess kit. The next one is another Coleman one. You can see right there. And this one, I believe, was $26. So, it's not a cheap mess kit. But, you know, I think you get what you pay for this one. So, the first bad thing about this one, and I'll start right off with it, is this bag. It has no way to contain itself like this lid does. It does not contain itself. So the way that you have to contain it is with this stuff sack right here. Yes, it nests onto it, but as you can see right there, stuff falls out. So, yes, you could, I guess, try and improvise some kind of way to keep that contained, and I may eventually do that. But for now, I guess this will work. But that's my first bad, bad check mark for that one. So, this one contains basically a small pot lid and or plate, I guess a bowl maybe, and then it has a small pot with the lid right there, and then it has, again, the large pot with the lid. Now, one thing I do like about this kit is the handles are good quality. I think they're pretty sturdy. I don't think you're going to bend them very easily, and they stay very nice and cool. As you saw, if you watched my 2011 backpacking trip, when we cooked beans and rice, this thing was sitting in the fire. Now, granted, there wasn't flame touching this the whole time, but they were sitting over some coals, some pretty hot coals, and these things were pretty much cool to the touch. So that I do give credit for. Another thing is, the handles for this, for the pot lids, are good quality. As you can see, what they do is they just pop in to those little slots, and then they lock in with the piece right here, and to get them off, you just squeeze it, and it goes back between in those little slats, and that locks it in, and then squeeze it, and it kind of self-closes. As you can see, it actually had a little bit of retention there. So that's good. Now, in terms of its effectiveness, I'd say it works pretty good. As you can see, it has a kind of enamel on it, this non-stick coating. And, you know, we didn't have any problems with it on the trip. We boiled it for about 2 hours. It sat in the fire. And as you can see, it's gotten a little black, and we did scrub it pretty hard with steel wool. See, there's no way you're really going to get all of that off. Yeah, I guess if you want to spend the time, you probably could. But even with that tough scrubbing, I don't really see any part of that non-stick coating that came off. So, in terms of the quality of the coating, I'd say that's pretty good. As you can see, it does have some measuring up in this side, and it measures up to 24 ounces on the outside and 800 milliliters on that side. So it does do metric and standard. And so it also has it on the outside, as you can see. Well, that's actually kind of... No, I'm sorry. It actually, they stamped it in, so this is the backward side of it, and then the regular side is right there. So this is the imprint where they stamped it in. And they do include sizes on the smaller pot too. So all in all, I think this mess kit is a lot better than this one. If you're talking about having a really good sturdy pot, the metal on this, you can hear it, it's much sturdier. I mean, I really can't flex that at all. This one, you could bend in half in about 5 seconds. But this mess kit feels a lot sturdier. Now, the only disadvantage is just a plate. But, you know, you could easily just eat straight out of that, and I wouldn't have any issue with that whatsoever. So all in all, it's a really good mess kit. And again, you actually have lots of, you have a pretty good cavity right here. So you could even combine mess kits if you wanted to. You could take the measuring cup, plop that in there, put the lid on, and there you go. You could take an alcohol stove. Let me get one of those real quick. You could easily fit several alcohol stoves in the bottom of this and have no problem. You could put a bunch of steel wool in here to clean it off. You could put your forks, you could put your knives, you could put your spices. So I think this is a really good cavity that you can put a lot of stuff in. So I like that feature. It gives you expansion for customization on your kit. I do apologize if I'm off camera here, guys. So I like that you can add more things to the mess kit. This one's pretty full to start off with, but this one you can add some stuff to it. So I would probably recommend this to someone. I think it's probably only worth about $20, though. I think $27 is a bit expensive for this one, but you know, it's not bad. Again, customize your mess kits. You can take different parts of each one and add them together to create your own personal kit. So make sure that you go out and you try things out before you stick with one thing. This is just an idea to help you see what to do. So I'll try and get out and get some more videos done for you guys. So stay tuned, guys, and I'll have another video for you shortly. Thanks.